Hello, this is Fightme, and in this video I will show you the positives and the negatives of Total War Troy. And I will give you my honest opinion if it's worth playing. To answer that question, we got to look at the content that the game has. Most of the time that exists of the campaign, the multiplayer, the historical battles, the playable factions, the unit variety, and the available mods. So let's look at the factions. There are 8 different factions in the game. That's already 2 less factions than the other Total War Saga game, Thrones of Britannia. And if we jump into the unit variety of each faction, it's actually looking pretty good. There are a lot of units that you can choose between, but there are of course also some units that are also in other factions, but overall there are a lot of different options and each faction looks pretty unique. If we now go to the section historical battles, there is none, which makes me a little bit upset. Because I love the historical battles, because you get to know a little bit more about the time area of the game, which for me just finishes a Total War game. So for me that's definitely a negative point. If we give a look at the multiplayer battles, the multiplayer is dead, unfortunately. But it's definitely understandable. After that delayed launch, you couldn't play multiplayer battles. Only after around a month. And then when you could play, there were a lot of bugs or crashes for the game. So because of all of that, people didn't touch the multiplayer again. Anyway, that's just very disappointing for me. But let's now talk about the stronger points of Total War Troy. We will be talking about the campaign soon, but first I want to address some other things. The music for the game is fantastic. It got one of the better soundtracks of all Total War games, but you can't compare it to Rome Total War, of course. The sound effects are also really satisfying, so that's a positive note for Total War Troy. Another positive thing is the looks of the game. The lighting looks fantastic, and the nature really stands out compared to other Total War games. But if you see the looks of the units, it's a whole other thing. Most of the units look really cartoonish, and the looks of the units isn't as real as in Total War Rome 2, Total War Attila, and Thrones of Britannia. But that's nothing compared to the combat animations, which totally ruins the battles for me. And the battles are in the top 3 things why I play Total War games. Because if you take a closer look, you can just see the units step in the air, and then you can see the other units just bounce back as if they hit each other. For me, that's one of the biggest downsides for the game. But the question is, can you fix this with mods? From what I know, there are 2 mods that can fix this a little bit. Those are these 2. One of them makes the death animations less retarded, and the other one makes more of the combat animations more realistic, like in Total War Rome 2. So I would say these are definitely needed. If we're starting to look at the generals, for the people that didn't like the one-man unit that can hold back hundreds of enemy units, there is now the option historical mode, which will 1. Delete the option to bring mythical units, and gives you the option to bring different bodyguards for your general, which I think is a really good improvement for the game, but also from CA, that they are listening to the community. If we now look at the balancing of the game, the elite spears feel the strongest. Maybe that's because they have a bonus versus cavalry, bonus versus axes, and bonus versus swordsmen. The chariots have been nerfed luckily, and the slingers outperform the archers, because in this game slingers can arc their shots like archers, which ruins the different playstyles for the units. Let's now look at the campaigns. There are currently a lot of people playing multiplayer campaigns. That's not a coincidence. The Total War Troy campaign is actually really good. With its new resource system, gives the campaigns a really unique touch, which will make Total War Troy stand out compared to other Total War games. For the playable campaign factions, there are 6 Danian factions that you can play as, each with a different difficulty, which is a nice addition. This way people will know how challenging their campaign will be. And furthermore, there are 4 Trojan factions that you can play as in the base game. The next few things are a little bit upsetting for me. The first one is the map sizes. They are way too small, especially the land battle maps. If you want to play 1v1, yeah, it's fine. But if you want to do a 3v3, 4v4 on such a map, it will be crammed with units and it won't be a fun time playing. So that's definitely a minor point for Total War Troy. And what I hate about the siege battles are you can't break the walls, which is a really important mechanic for Total War games. In most of the Total War games, there's artillery, cannon fire, or tortoises that can break the walls. But in this game, there's none. This gives the attackers one less option to get in the city. And this forces them to attack on the walls or try to get through the gate, which is really punishing for the attackers, and it makes the siege battles less dynamic. The first thing is you can't select different seasons. And that's really shocking for me. For me, the seasons make the battles way more immersive. Being able to fight on a snowy map just makes it for me. But now they added a decent compensation for it, which is called photo mode. It's basically an in-game reshader, which is very useful, which can be used in many ways. For example, to change the daylight of the battle, which is pretty cool to be honest, or make it rainy. You can even make it night. You can really do whatever. You can make the game look how you want it to look. And it's perfect for making perfect looking screenshots. You can add even a logo on a screenshot. So those were the ups and downs for Total War Troy. And the question is it now worth playing? Well, if you really enjoy the campaigns, yeah, for sure. But if you're more planning to play multiplayer, then I think this is not the right game for you. Then I would suggest Rome 2 for you. And talking about Rome 2, if you want to know 10 tips that will make you win every battle, make sure to watch this. And I will see you guys there. Bye bye.